Holy Wire Mod here, and this is going to be tutorial 13C in the Expression 2 series, where we're going to be doing a continuation of functions, and this time we're going to be involving tables in the equation. So let's create some function right here, some func, and we'll say it's this, which is type table, and we're going to grab the index of this, and we're going to bring this over to the function that we're creating. So let's open and close with curly brackets. And we're going to print this index, which is of type string, or whatever type that you're using in your table. And let's say that every interval of 1,000 milliseconds, so 1 second, we will put variable string as a method to call. If you recall from last video, we use the same exact method. And we're also going to say string is table, and it's going to be a table of names. So we're going to have Sandy, we're going to have Ricky, we're going to have Bobby, we're going to have my boy Jamal, my cousin Pedro, and Soon is a good guy too. You like Soon? I feel like we need another female name. Let's do Linda. And what's that last guy's name? Oh yeah, his name is John Cena. All right, very good. All right, so let's do Randint right here. Actually, you know what, just for simplicity's sake, let's put the value 3 here. So we're going to close this line right here like that, and notice this table and index right here, this number here is an index, is in the same exact format as this up here. And that's done on purpose. So it's going to grab the third index from this table, which is Bobby, bring it through here, and print that right here. All right? So that's what it does. So again, if we put 1, it'd be Sandy. If we put 4, it'd be Jamal. And if we put Randint, 0 through 8, which I believe we have 8 entries, yes we do, then it will be a random name generator. Isn't that nice? So there is another way to actually structure this function right here. Instead of doing some func, you actually can put table first some func and then get rid of it here, and you don't have to reference the name of the table being called, and you'll take the index right here. And the only important thing to mention that this function is referencing is that string right here as some func, and the title here is some func, so they're connected through some func. So anyway, it'll do the exact same thing when I upload it, as you can see. Now, something interesting to note when you're dealing with functions is sometimes maybe you want to do a local string or a local variable. Now, local means that if I define something inside this function, it cannot be used outside of the function because it is local to being inside the function, okay? So what if I say that the local variable is equal to this local, and let's give it some variable name. We'll say string. Clever, I know. And we'll print string. So notice that it works. Now, if I put the print command out here, there's going to be an error because it doesn't exist. It hasn't been defined outside of here, whereas it has been up here. That's why it works. All right? So that's pretty much what local does, if you're curious. So if I were to put it out here, like local string equals whatever, so we'll say whatever, it's not going to see string up here, because when it's local out here, it's not within the confines of the function right here. Alright? So, if you have any questions about local, we can get into that into more detail, but this is going to cover the remainder of the function. And if you have any more issues with that as well, feel free to contact me, and I will see you in the next video.